meeting right now?
The meeting starts at 6:30, that's what you gotta leave.
On your way.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I could sit here, doesn't that good?
I'll be done in a minute.
No, that's all right.
12:07, I know. It's got four pages. All right, here's another, oops. There's another 12:07. Again, you had it or Doug had it.
He's got it.
And Dawn, here is you one.
Actually, years ago, I had this steel-looking thing that went back, it was 34 years ago, I used to keep it with me for jobs. Bang, you just, nice big metal thing.
Did it have the big round?
Had a round head, red head on it. And I had this thing, I always kept it with me for jobs.
My dad told me about that time.
I kept it with me, and it finally got jammed up a few years ago.
The staplers?
I had to let it go.
My dad told me about that.
It did.
The Navy still uses them.
It was that old, it had a brand, it was antique.
I'm sure some stapler collector somewhere has one of those.
All right, oh. Let's see. Here's 12:31. And...
Soil conservation, but in my town.
12:31.
There's old stuff.
12:31.
Dawn, do you have a particular order that you wanna go in that makes more sense for your operation?
Which hat are you wearing first?
That's your number one, okay.
12:05, Superior Court then, right? No, 213. 213? Okay. Which we really don't say.
213.
Well, we have four general fund departments and two other funds. What do you want to do first?
Special revenue.
Get this out of the way.
Yeah, they're saying really have no...
They are what they are.
Which one?
213, Fund 213, which is drug abuse.
Okay.
State fund.
And then the DUI?
No. And then the...
Drug court. Yep, 246.
DUI Court Supervisor.
Okay.
Why am I in here?
There it is.
All right. 213. Back in special funds. The date tab.
Yes.
You said say?
Should I say?
Yeah.
Bring a bottle.
I always bring a bottle, when necessary.
And not that. I meant the wide, not the narrow thing.
Not at work.
No, not that.
All right, Dave, we'll go again, start it, Dave, you wanna give your opening comments?
My preamble is Tim called yesterday. They know the whole thing. No, I just tend to highlight a few of the significant changes that are affecting all departments across the entire budget. Primarily, well, some of the different, we have the general funds, but as far as all departments are concerned, whether they're in or out of the general fund, in the personnel section, when there is personnel, and this one doesn't have it, but true in the other part, there's three lines that are significantly changed in the primary budget, which you may have already noticed. One is in the healthcare insurance line, because the program had some high claims costs last year, and so we've added about 18% of total cost, it's equating out to about 16% increase, depending if people got moved around in the coverage. But if same to same, it's about 16% in every department's budget, that's up. The pension account line, which is the 401K, is currently 3%. The provision for that reduced to 3%, it's supposed to sunset each year, so by the time the preliminary budget gets to the board on the 12th of June, that will go back up to 5%, and they'll do what they will do with it, whether they put it back 3 or 4, whatever they do. So that will go from the current 3 in there up to 5. There's an increase in health insurance, and the other line is the one that's called, the right title, departments here. The personal leave sold, which was frozen until last year, we weren't sure last year how much of that was, you know, people catching up with what had accumulated in their account. But what we did was we took the first 4 months of payrolls of this year and projected it out and put that in the budget for all the departments, which is higher than what was budgeted before, and comes out similar to a lot of departments last year, so that's a calculated number. Whether that will stay there or not yet through all the budget process, we're not sure. As far as whether or not that program may be looked at next year, whether there's any limits to it or not, I don't know. But right now, it's just purely a calculated number projecting the next year what this year's personally we've sold is. And yeah, whether we back off that number or not, we'll look at the balance. If the balances are dropping a lot, then it may be that just people will not keep selling that much next year. So that's the three lines there. When we get into the general fund, what you'll have already noticed in some of your departments is we're recommending this year to close three of the internal service fund departments and move them back into the general fund, which means we're not going to allocate them between general fund departments. So what you'll see in general fund departments, the admin fund charge will go to zero. There's one we have over there in my house, so I love it, zero.
Okay.
Oh, you'll see it later.
All right.
So the admin charge will go to zero. If you have any GIS charges, I'm not sure if any of your departments do or not, but if so, they go to zero. And in particular, the public facilities, your public building line will go to zero. So it's just all provided through the general fund. There won't be any charges for that. And the general fund departments. Now, these two departments, we'll see if there's any central service charges or not. There may not be.
There are not special.
These two. These two. Some funds do, usually if they have personnel, they have some of that. And that's about it for significant changes. Other than that, we'll go through what's been submitted and look at prior year, current year.
So when we get back from y'all out in the finance committee, they will see all these changes.
Yeah, some of them are in there now, but the one going back to 5% will be in there.
Yes, you'll see
for that. For the June 12th preliminary budget.
All right.
But that's just to highlight what happened to three of those lines. And that's about it. One other change, which will affect some areas, I'm not sure you've seen this from us yet or not, but although the burn grants, they mostly ended, you still...
They end 2012, but there is... Yeah, there's a couple of those. There's that, and then there's also the admin office of the courts grant, and that's in 2013.
Yeah. So we're setting up a grants fund. Those grants will be, they may show them here now for comparison purposes, but that time again, we give the, did you get them out of this one?
They're in the grant fund.
Okay.
So
they will be in new grant fund, related expenses we can put over there. That makes it, it's a lot easier to report on and keep track of the grant funds.
Okay.
And to the extent that there's a county match for that, we would show a transfer from the general fund to the grant fund.
So all we'll be seeing in the special revenue then is the actual revenue that comes in from the court.
Actual court revenues correct. And general fund.
Yes, less
funding.
The grant. That is correct. Right.
Yep.
Right.
Yeah, state and federal grants are over.
Yeah.
That's it. Now I think it covers it. And with that, you want to start with the drug abuse and treatment education fund?
Sure. The proposed state fund 2013 budget has been given to the board and they have approved it and submitted it. I really have nothing else to go on. All monies that are left over from prior year stay with that. And so they've had to project out what they anticipate that to be.
On the revenue side, that's been in, which it's been increasing or it's at least been over budget. And that was your submittal. If you increase that to 100,000 for drug education, and that we have those revenue lines, or that was
they
your submission?
They did those revenue lines. Yep.
And we've already booked 40,000 for the first 3 months. That might be a month later. So it looks like we could be heading for 120 again. Again, this all stays within one fund. It will balance the whole thing out. So I don't know if you just want to keep it at 100 or.
It's been approved by the board. I don't know.
So,
to say
okay. Oh, they approved the revenue numbers too?
Everything.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. That's fine. All we have to do then is balance it out. Okay. So all the numbers that are in here as of now was what that board. Which is around $100. Make it pounds.
Oh, is that what all it is? Okay, yeah. That might have been in FICA. The United Way grant, Don, that actually would stay in this fund because it's not a state or federal.
Okay,
just FYI. And there won't be a problem with that being moved to the grant fund since the board. But is that okay?
Good.
I'll have to ask them.
Okay.
I'll see if there's anything. Okay. Anything we need to do. Yeah, we should have emailed you a copy of the grant fund showing that. Okay.
They didn't know that we look for a balance between revenue and expenditures on this type of account. We would typically go through perhaps any increases, not all, but some of the larger increases for discussion purposes. Don, do you want to touch on any of those, or Dave, do you see any that you want to discuss? And do we want to look at the $900 $100.
$100.
Difference.
Yeah, we can balance that out.
Yeah.
Do you have the authority to balance that? You don't, okay.
I do not, I will have to give it to the board. And I can only present this one.
Okay. That's fine.
Since it is a board.
Okay, we can work on that.
And the balance, I mean, it's $100, Don, if you just want to see where they want to. Where is that?
We can do this, that's it.
It's the difference between your revenue of $146 and your expenditures of $145.9.
Is this for this year?
We just balance it out.
2013.
Yeah, 2013.
So I have this.
That's what you submitted.
This is what I have.
Let's see. It's probably the salaries part-time. Yeah, I think what it is part of the salaries part-time went to the grant fund. So part of the FICA and part of the part-time salaries went to the grant fund, and that's probably how we got off $100, because, you know, we rounded to the nearest center.
When we pulled out the.
We pulled it out. We pulled out $5,000 in part-time, and then we pulled out $400 in FICA. And then the others.
How much was that, Trey?
The others.
All right, we can balance it.
We can just balance that out. And it won't come, we'll balance it out up in the lines that we provide numbers for. Is that right, Amanda?
Well.
As opposed to operating.
We sit like that, is that how you want to balance it, or?
That's just the line for the numbers.
The numbers I have are different, so I have $184.9, and you have that $140.
It's the grant. The grant's the issue.
So, your information, will you have this updated?
That's right.
Because I pulled this off.
SharePoint actually is what we use, what we get off SharePoint, we use to enter the budget. But after that, SharePoint doesn't talk to our budget.
Did I get prompted?
I emailed it to you. I did.
All right.
I can make you some copies of these.
Now, again, the grant we pulled out was the Georgia Admin Office, the courts grant, which was how much?
$38.9.
And then what went to that was part of the salaries and some other expenses.
That's right. Salaries and FICA, and some of the other expenses, yes. You want me to have Ron make you a copy?
If I could, if it's not.
So you have the same thing?
I don't have anything like that for any of these.
Okay.
If I can get it, I'm sorry.
That's okay, that's all right. That way you'll have what we have. All right, hold on, there's more. Six.
Is that grant doing that one for? It says Georgia Admin Office, of course, is that grant, is that one that's applied for and approved, and they have to grant reporting off and stuff on it? Okay, yeah, it did, it's just being the grant fund. That way it's not commingled with these other dollars. Is that grant stand completely on its own, doesn't have a match? No match, okay, and then, yeah, it's a lot longer to put in the grant fund, I was debating. Do I have to stay here or not?
No, we don't have any that require any matches, we just.
So then what this fund will end up with will be just the drug education dollars, the drug court dollars, and I would agree on that.
There's six of them, and then the things that move to the grant fund, I'll have to get those too.
You know what, I'm too.
That's okay, don't worry about it. Because I want you to have them and make sure everything looks good, so. The fund. Drug court. Okay, this should do it. Just make her one copy.
All right, so you're gonna fix that salary, the $100 discrepancy?
We can pick my state line, we just have to add $100.
I can add $100 in. If that's okay, you need operating line to balance it.
The bigger things is probation drug testing.
Would that be okay?
Yes.
Okay. Because if it's not, she just.
Okay.
I didn't look up the balances before I came, but I noticed last year, compared to revenues, it was well under the revenues that came in, which means then that it's building up the fund balance. I don't know how large the balance is. If each year the contingency budget revenues and expenses for those, we'll never touch that cash balance unless there's a shortfall some year. But at some point it's large enough, if there's other things that this board needs to do with this program, especially if it's a one-time type of thing, we could budget some of that to get in balance and use it instead of just sitting.
Right, and it can only be used for drug abuse and treatment education. Mm-hmm. And I know that last year they had a lot of requests that actually came in, and they funded things that they hadn't before for the Forsyth County schools, which is going to be in that report that we're going to make next week. Because they had lost a grant, and so they kind of picked it up and supplied things for them. And I know that drug testing is done on most of Judge Dickinson's criminal cases now too, that was picked up last year as well. So they're expending the funds.
Okay.
All right. So seems, you got 246?
246. DUI Court Admin Fund, which is funded by supervision fees. The United Way grant, and in this case we did show how much of a fund balance was there if you need to. We only set that up as a contingency last year. We have not set that up yet this year. I'm not sure what we're going to go for, but.
Oh, they gave me that number.
How much they want to use fund balance?
They gave me that number. But did it balance the fund though?
No, we still need more of the cash balance to balance that compared to the expenditure side.
Oh, you know what the problem is? The grant got moved. That's what it is. So
there's a grant there as well.
Yes.
Did the expenses come out to go with it?
Yes. They did.
Okay.
That's odd. Well,
what that means is the remaining revenues aren't covering the rest. Now, again, if we have a cash balance and cover it, that can help in the short term, that once that's used, it's not available every year. Special line down there, GAOC.
The grant, yeah, and it was $17,000.
Okay.
And then the.
Let's see.
Yeah, and that matches the revenue exactly. So. We added the cell phone. Oh, let's see, no.
Well, if you take out the contingency and the grant, it's 62.7. 44, it's probably only up about $2,000 or $3,000. Salaries are down, so yeah, it's very close to what it was last year. Just that our supervision fee, maybe coming that number down, we've got the supervision fee down to 17,000.
Mm-hmm.
How are we doing this year? It's 246. So prior year was 37,000. 10-8, I'm not sure if that's a month delayed or not. If it's a month delayed, that would be a quarter. So you can still run, if that's a quarter, you'd still be running around 40,000. Even if that's 4 months, you're still going to have over 30,000. I'm just wondering if that 17,000 in revenues, that should be brought back up, and that would help.
I can take it to the steering committee.
You know what? That's
is that who helped with this budget? Is the steering committee for this?
I see what it is. That the DUI supervision fee should be $48,000.
Oh, it was 17 the uh-huh. grant amount?
17 was the grant amount.
Okay.
17 got moved.
That
so that's let's redo the numbers here.
We need to fix our number then.
Yeah.
48.
62
plus that adds
31.
63
and
62.3.
Okay, I'll fix that, Bob.
We're there. Problems solved.
Balanced.
Yeah.
Just like in the world. They submitted it, right?
See, they did. Is that, yeah.
That was a test.
Yeah, and that was, that's good. That's very good.
Okay, that's, that, I feel better about it. That looks like the way, that looks like the way it's going.
Yeah, it was when we moved the grant stuff. We just bumped that 17.
And then that's why they put 9,300 in at the beginning balance was what was needed to balance the fund.
That's exactly right.
Now I know where the 9,300 came from.
Anything more on that one?
All right, and we're the general fund.
And you'll see, Dawn, that the grant piece is in Fund 207, and there's copies of that as well.
So where did you get?
Which one do you want to start with? 1205?
1205.
Or your 1205? Superior. Superior Court. There's an empire. That's of course the field court.
All right.
Okay, this is where we're. This is where we're up in the personnel section, it's just these increases from personally sold and health insurance. Push that out. The other side's almost, it's only $1,000 difference in total. So court reporter fees during this year. That's recorded running about $12,000 a month, which would be, which is $1,144. One grips. That would be right on the budget.
Yes.
Thing about numbers like that, it's, you know, really influence, it's almost estimating what might happen, because it is just based on caseload and jury trials and.
Right, absolutely. And our, the current court reporter for Judge Bagley and everything, when she used to hold everything till the end, and so now we have other people.
Yeah, they turn their bills in late before, you know.
Now they're having other people do the majority of it the last couple of months, and so they turn them in regularly, so they're helping with the budget.
It's the new judge and the new budget.
Yeah, that'll be talked about as a new item. Any other questions there that they're operating on and stuff?
I don't. There's a slight increase, but, very slight, under operating, $1,000.
And I think that probably came from the healthy water service that went up from procurement. Everything else, oh, paper, an additional 200 paper because we went over last year by a couple hundred dollars.
Is that coffee and water service a contracted service?
Yes. I think we're one of the postage. Yes, we did.
I don't have any questions.
No.
Pretty much tracks about the same.
We're gonna handle the new budget item separate, okay, call it one time?
Yeah.
Or you wanna handle it?
Well, either way, we're in Superior Court now, we can talk about it now, or.
Let's handle it in the fund, yeah, if you don't mind.
Okay.
New piece of paper. Go to the new, do we have it somewhere, it's up in the new?
In the front, or?
Yeah, it's around the front.
Because we need to try to pull this whole thing together, because it hits several offices.
Yes, the judgeship's gonna be, yeah, GF-1 through 7, but that includes other elected officials, constitutional officers.
Yeah, but I think we need to pull together, even if it's other offices, we can talk to them about it, and their budgets, we probably need to get all the costs, I think, together.
Yes.
All at once, best we can.
Okay.
To the extent that don't be familiar with what's been turned in.
Right, and I've got a total cost for this judgeship for everybody.
Okay.
The only thing I do want to bring up on that judgeship, on the staffing request, and you probably already corrected it in there, the supplement in the, for the new Superior Court judge, need to make sure we add on all the FLS, all of the FICA.
Okay.
And things, because you put that in as per what the local legislation requires.
So it's like, it's the supplement plus FICA?
Yes.
Okay.
And we
should be calculating that.
That's what I was hoping.
I'll double check, but
I wanted to make sure.
Yeah, okay.
Is that the number that you sent me earlier, the 1912?
We did. We got it. Yes. It's $1,912.
Okay.
Yes. I caught it.
Great. Wonderful. And then the only other one I was wondering about was the law assistant clerk for the judge.
Okay.
The salary being requested is at the midpoint of the grade where they're asking 62,919, and the minimum for that is 50,300. And I know state court just hired in December someone around 51, so I didn't know if they wanted to consider anything different, you know.
I don't know. I know that the state court has done that the last couple times they've looked for law clerk because of the budget issues that have happened, because prior to that it was always much higher, it was always at the midpoint. We'll have to ask the new judge what they want to do and come before the board, I guess. I'm really not sure. We cannot, it's not up to us to hire them. It would be up to the judge.
I know, but I was just concerned about the budgeting. I'm not saying about the hiring. It's just because, you know, then you'd be bringing in someone that is a new clerk, actually higher than what they have been here a year.
But it's a different court with much different responsibilities.
Okay, state versus superior.
Okay.
Who is the list? What's in the 125,000 salaries? There's a number of different things in there, right? Some is supplements, some is positions.
Yeah, okay, so it would be, let's see. It makes up the supplement for the judge.
For the judge supplement, which is the 25?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that includes FICA of $1,912.
Okay.
And then it includes the supplement for the judicial secretary.
Secretary supplement.
Uh-huh. And that's $14,000 for the supplement, and then the FICA is $1,071. And then
some full positions in there. Right?
Okay. And then the law assistant, law clerk. I'll just give you the total because it's salary plus benefits.
Okay.
That's $83,432.
That's the one I just was talking about.
That would have to be
subject
to.
So 120, it works about there then, right? Yeah, that's it, I guess. There's
that
three.
It?
There's three.
Can we add a mixture?
No, that's real close.
19, 120 with the FICA, so 120.
Oh, okay.
That's probably about
okay.
it.
Okay, that should be it.
Rounding.
That should be it. So that's the salaries and benefits. Yeah, okay. And then there's operating expenses associated with that as well.
Yeah. Look, let me ask Dawn, and looking at, so trying to match this up so we can explain it well to the board too, and the Superior Court budget. We have two judges in there now?
Yes.
Okay. And it's 50, 39 times 2 BC. What's in the personnel now there? There's the two judges' supplements. Is there two secretaries in there?
The only thing in there right now are supplements for two judges, supplements for two secretaries, supplement for one law clerk, and one full-time law clerk county employee.
So there's one law clerk and two judges and two secretaries. Is that it?
No.
I missed one more. What's the other one?
You have supplements for two judges, two secretaries, one law clerk, and then one county employee law clerk.
Oh, supplement for a law clerk.
Which is a law assistant, yes.
This one here is salary for one law clerk.
Yeah.
Okay, so there is two law clerks, so we're, there's a total of, oh, let's divide that. Total of six there now, this adds three more.
Going back to, don't want to stop, you can go ahead and do a budget item worksheet. I know it says various operating expenses, courtroom offices, chambers, but any space, additional space needs for this is in facilities budget, it's not?
That's the capital number you seem to know.
Okay.
Yeah, you want to talk about the, what's in the, what's anticipated in the $230,000 for capital?
If we're there.
Or you want to, well, I'll go across the operating expenses, $105,300. Current Superior Court has $176,500, two judges. Do you have what the, what's in $105,300?
And they did a great job of breaking it out and made it easy for us to enter. They actually took another budget worksheet and labeled it new judgeship, so I have the actual line items.
Just listed these amounts down?
Yeah, they did. They listed them for me.
Okay.
So, it's various, you know, a row.
One half of that, I guess, well, okay, that's $96,800. We're showing in this report, that's where I was at, $105,000.
Yeah, so it's, let's see. So that's $97,300, and then $8,000 in IT requests. So that would be their computers and printers, let's see. Three computers, two laptops, and then four printers. And one of the printers was a high-volume printer.
Okay, so the actual operating, excuse me, operating was AD?
Go back.
AD here, $97,300?
Yeah, $97,300.
And IT was?
$8,000.
$8,000.
Yep. And that's where we got that number.
Yeah, if you take the $176,500 and half, you get $88,000. Yeah, it's about $9,000 more per judge, but there might be some startup stuff in there, I would guess.
I think there was a desk in there, wasn't there?
Oh, there's just some branches in there, okay.
And a robe, and the robe. Robe, all of the office furniture. We'd also need probably some type of evidence presentation system, which Kevin Love was able to put one together for state court judges for a reasonable amount a couple of years ago.
There was more travel initially, so I had to get some people up to speed.
New judgeship, new judge training, new law firm training.
Other than that, everything is about one half of the two judges.
Right, and that was how it was.
Okay, now, on to the capital.
All right, the capital, let's see.
$230,000.
She don't have something.
Just to be fair on that particular item, with respect to offices, for the offices that maybe need either for office staff or the new judgeship, we're still working on that. I'm sure that Don did the best she could, staff did the best they could, put those numbers together. We're still trying to nail that down.
Okay, the estimates used were 10,000 square feet of lease space at $12 a foot. And the courtroom setup for IT security and sound systems, $135,000. And then construction costs for developing. So actually, I guess putting this, it's all approved to put the space in the courtroom configuration, everything we need. So that's how that breaks down. $120,000, which would be the repetitive cost year to year.
Right.
$75,000 is lease hold improvements plus $35,000 for IT, so that's where you get the $230,000 from. Okay. So of course, like you said, the whole, and then you did fine. The whole question is just what space,
yeah,
where, what lease.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, Don submitted it unknown.
Mm-hmm.
That
sure.
Came in with the numbers.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the capital is a question mark. What we do know,
right,
is basically
right.
The quarter million, not quite, $230,000 in operating and salary costs.
Is that location, you know, we're just talking about a separate location?
Lease space would be something additional.
Yeah, so we're talking lease space, so there's other costs you got to think in there. So if we got to connect that building back, if it's going to be around here, do we want to put it on the fiber campus? Do we want to have a lease line for data services? Then you'll have switch costs and whatever data cabling costs. So remember that one.
Okay. And I think looking at these numbers, I think we got some room flexibility in that.
Just making it heard, that's all.
And time clock.
And time clock.
Yeah. They're not cheap.
Okay.
Okay, then the rest of the costs are related or spill over, costs to other departments. Well, you can address several of them, I guess, Tom, right?
Yeah, she could talk about the criminal calendar clerk and the bailiff, additional bailiffs.
Right, we would need additional bailiffs because we're actually hiring two right now because we've lost several and a couple off due to illness, so they would need at least two pretty normal bailiffs. Right now, each of our judges has one or two. Not normal, Edward.
As opposed to, what's that mean, Dawn?
Regular working bailiffs for jury trials. And then usually one or the other takes the rest of the month. So additional bailiffs and then a criminal calendar clerk. We currently have just one and she's more than overwhelmed. There's no way to get another one without getting an additional calendar clerk. And then pretrial services, I'm also handling theirs. They need an additional person as well.
Pretrial release officer is the last item under the judgeship.
Can we go back to the bailiff?
Mm-hmm.
Pat, do you have anything on that? What is, are those... Those are full-time positions?
No, they're per diem. They're $70 a day per diem.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And we currently have a long list, and a lot of them are just on there, just in case, but it doesn't cost any additions.
Okay.
Do we have some of that? How do we have a list on here? Do we have a big operating expense? Do we put some of it there? Or?
Operating is the juror...
Probably.
Fees.
Yeah, the juror.
The juror fees, the juror meals and lodging, and then interpreters.
Let's do the
regular. Court reporter, big increase in court reporter. Well, yeah, the interpreters would be in 1207, but court reporter went up significantly because you have an additional court going, so you need that. Everything else was just like within a couple, $2,000-$3,000 at the most. Some of it was just like 500, 800, that type of thing. But the biggest increase in the 1205 budget would be for court reporters going up from 147 in 1202 to 2500 in 2013.
Which budget was that in?
You said 1205, Dawn?
1205.
Let me just make sure that's in there. Just want to be sure.
Okay, we caught that. That was
735.
That was in the operating cost of that.
Right.
What
else were you asking?
Moving down the court administration.
The bailiffs.
77.5 there, which I think is the juror fees.
Bailiffs, juror fees, court interpreters, and additional supplies for
the jurors.
The jurors, meals and lodging, and calendar and clerk. And
the bailiffs are by themselves on the line. The GF3s and the bailiffs. That's got the bailiffs and the jurors in it.
Oh, I see.
And then the criminal calendar clerk is, that's just for the criminal calendar.
Okay, I got it. There's two lines. Plus 40.
I had mine separated out by
You made it really easy for us to enter. Thank you.
I thought I could do that for y'all.
It helped. We would have gotten lost. If you hadn't, we probably would have gotten lost.
If you hadn't, I would have gotten home.
Yeah.
Thank you, Don.
Well, it also made it easier to fill out the new budget position stuff.
Yeah.
And then I just added it all.
Right. It was really nice.
And you're the only one that really, which I watched up the budget certainly, but today we're on this subject now. Is that a pretrial services? Yeah.
A new release officer.
They monitor individuals who are out on bond and appear in court.
Maybe you can help me. I've been trying to understand events in a lot of different settings, but adding another judge does not make more cases happen out there, you know, there's more arrests, more so on. There's a backlog now which you have to deal with. And for example, the release officer, there's still just as many pre-arraignments and out and bond and releases, there's a backlog of cases. What does this mean, and guess how they handle the disposition of cases might be different?
Well, the problem
what happens if we catch up with the backlog,
right,
for example?
Why we only have two is over the past 2 or 3 years, we've had to cut out doing things. We've cut out doing monitoring on misdemeanors, except for a few that are coming through Superior Court. So it would mean going back to the way pretrial services was originally set up, doing the work that it was originally set up to do. And as well, when you have three judges and two people and they're all doing criminal at the same time and you need someone in each court, you don't have
right.
a warm body to be there.
That means in some cases they may be brought back in more often because there's three judges,
yes.
so you can schedule more.
Yes.
So I'm thinking the disposition of how this case is handled is going to be a little bit different.
Right. Additionally, we've had to, we haven't been taking really any more people who are ankle monitors because there's only one individual right now to oversee that, and that involves, it's very time intensive, like nights, weekends, any time that thing goes off, mm-hmm. you're responsible for it. And this would allow for them to be able to start taking them again because you'd be able to have two people.
I guess put another way, having a same, you know, so many arrests, same caseload, but three judges instead of two, are there any efficiencies gained through the three compared to two that the county would see in any way other than processing, getting them through the court system sooner?
That's how you judge everything in the judiciary, is getting through access
right.
to justice and getting through sooner. Other than being able to assist other judges with their monitoring like they did in the past, you're not going to see any financial gain or anything like that for the county, but it will help the efficiencies in magistrate
mm-hmm.
court and state court and superior court, as well as with the DA's office and drug court. And the individuals who are being monitored will see a difference too. They will have more open office hours and not have cattle call on basically Monday, Wednesday, Friday from 8 a.m. until.
And we anticipate these efficiencies carrying over into the new courthouse.
Then when you get into there.
As well.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Anything else?
Okay. Yeah. Well,
back to the.
Well, for 1205.
We'll go to the budgets, but I guess we'll talk
12.
To the DA about they're wanting to add it.
Right.
Get into the new judgeship, adding a new prosecutor and a new investigator. And I guess, again, because the cases will move along quicker. To me, again, there's the same number of cases that. DA has to deal with, but
well, it's not
like
really
you say in different courtrooms again. Too.
Right now they have individual investigators and DAs assigned to an individual
judge
handling
okay.
those,
that's what
and
is.
They can't be in two places at once. That's
right.
Why okay. they're required to have additional.
And then
staff.
In the sheriff's office, we end up with three deputy sheriff twos and a sergeant.
We're oh yeah,
well,
it's three. Yeah, three deputy
sheriffs. Sheriff about what they're for, unless you're familiar with those. That's just the overall security for them. And I don't know if any of that's going to go to whether or not it's in a separate site or not. I mean, if the third judge is in the courthouse, we'll ask the sheriff about the three
right.
different deputies and the sergeant.
Right.
I can see if the third courtroom is another site, probably need some sheriff
right. if,
security.
You know, if they have to hold court in any other site, be it magistrate or juvenile or those two places really would be the only place, they would have to be escorted until they got there. There are two deputies in any court at any given time.
Okay, we can ask sure. Then again, they may have been anticipating if this was at another site, that we just kind of put a wall glass issue would be for that.
But until we find that out, we really don't know.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, well, it's all laid out here pretty clear with your help. Thank you.
So you want to do?
One.
All right, back to the budget.
Well, are you still on pretrial or going on something else?
We go to the next slide. I was trying to finish up with the new judgeship.
Just the judgeship.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Because I heard that this
we have
a pretrial.
But you did. They did.
Yeah. And I guess my question was there were actually two things submitted for pretrial release. One was for a new position, and one was for a reclass of the existing one. Is that still then on the books? Or
yes. With an additional staff person. he would request a reclass for the current position that is there so that they can start taking those ankle monitoring responsibilities as well. Because right now, he is the director is the only one who's authorized to do that. And if you're starting to take ankle monitors, all of that responsibility for an additional agent would be upon him. And so he would ask for a reclass to be able to have someone that can relieve him. Not all individuals are going to have to be at that level, but he would request that one be, and then one be at the current level that's there.
Okay, that was one of my questions.
Yes.
I just wanted to clarify. And if that does, if the reclass does go through the budget, I'll get with you and Jamie about ACPQ getting done, and that
yes.
way we can get it correctly graded.
Yes.
All right, we're ready for the next
yes.
operating budget.
Yes.
The report administration for all those said.
Okay.
And this one, we have one adjustment on the second page for the. That's where we have the open fund charge there.
Okay, yeah. I'll ask Amin about that. I do have one line item correction that we have to move the $75,000 up to the regular paid off line, not down the burn line. Oh, that's right.
See that? We did $75,000.
Yes.
We'll correct that.
And then what ends up on the burn?
Zero.
Zero.
Yeah, no grants over here. If there is any burn grant, I'll
check on
that.
Yeah, unless the middle it was 75. Okay, yes, I will get that.
And it's up in the revenue section. There is no grant monies.
Okay.
So this is all county dollars, if you will. Yeah. We'll go over the operating expenses. Everything else is pretty straightforward. So, their health care actually went down. That might be central dental
yep.
take coverage. What we did see some of, for example, some if they're not taking coverage, and they need to take coverage, that would go down, depending who they have. Probably what the drop in healthcare was.
Yes, that's probably why your
okay.
yours is a little different.
All right, want to go over to operating expenses?
Yes.
Let's look at your date on how we're doing with jury fees. Jury fees, right? We've already booked half of this year's budget through a quarter of the year, a third of the year, probably.
Well, the difference, what the judges started doing at the end of last year is doing, they had scheduled actually for this year, and then they already decided to do it after the budget had gone through, because they currently set 2 criminal jury trial weeks every other month, so you're doing back-to-back jury trial weeks, and you're having all those jurors come in for 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why the costs are going up. They anticipate doing that again in 2013. I'm not sure about with the new judge because he or she would be new and
mm-hmm.
learning,
mm-hmm.
And then we may not have space to do 2 week back-to-back jury trials.
Other than maybe coming on, how does that increase the jury costs? You still have so many jury trials, right? But
no,
just because they're keeping the pool together?
There are more jury trials.
They have
more. Everything's moving through faster, you don't have the backlog.
Okay. So that's part of moving more trials
yes.
through.
And it's not just criminal, it's the civil stuff too.
Okay.
In an efficient court, that's the way it should
right.
be. You should be having trials, both civil and criminal jury trials, on a regular basis, and because of the backlog, mm-hmm. you know, you still have to hear adoptions, you still have to have bench trials, you still have to do everything normally, and so setting aside a week at a time is sometimes difficult when you have a backlog.
Oh, let's see, interpreters. This, not too bad last year, the actual, but the budget is saying, but, we booked 14,000 so far this year. Depending if that's a, yeah, it would be right in between if it's 3 or 4 months.
Even if it's 4 behind,
4 to 2, 56.
We'll be having big bills for this month. We had trials last week, and we had 2 or 3 interpreters there every day.
Mm-hmm. And that's where most of your operating costs are, where there's two lines there.
We may be seeing an increase in interpreters next year as well. With SAFT got a big grant to do custodial changes, mm-hmm. and if that's going to be ordered, and there's a problem with communication, since it's court ordered, we will have to pay for it.
There is one new line. You're going to get that subscription to model railroading, right?
Yeah.
If it's subscription, there's a new line. It's all locked up.
Yes, because we used to have it, and then we took it out, and now we're robbing Peter to pay Paul, so we wanted to put it back.
down on admin, fund, that'll go to 0 for the 9,000.
Yeah, I'm going to get a minute and take a look at that. That will be.
Other than that,
should be 0 in version.
And the IT amount's probably going to change and correct that allocation.
Yeah, the IT amount will change.
Along with the workers' comp one, too. It's probably interesting. Other than that, though, operating expenses,
no,
Doug?
The juror fees, because we went over so far last year, and we're anticipating being able to that and the $500, $300 in office supplies, because we, as you can see, we went over in 2011, and we had just budgeted the same. That was back when they changed court interpreters and bailiffs to court administration, and then we didn't get any of the supply monies to go
okay.
with it. And so even this year, we're like down to a couple $100 for the rest of the year. So it's adding in.
Yeah. Fact is, if you take out some of the grant dollars, I'm going to see 7, 10, 15, 217. Yeah, you'd be just, the prior year actual just be a few thousand below where your proposed budget is.
Right, that's right. That's right.
And you don't anticipate any management professional services needs?
The only reason they were in there now is we have a grant that pays for senior judges.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, that was grant funded. Yeah.
Okay.
Not in court admin.
Okay.
And good. One new budget item in court admin, which would be the, what was it on?
IT
position.
The IT,
yeah, that's right.
Business processor, I believe. Yeah.
That's right.
Process coordinator.
To new items?
Yeah, so go back to new items. And it is GF8.
Tell us about that.
IT business process coordinator. This was actually planned and approved, and not approved. It had been planned and it was going to go before the board. It was on the books. I can't remember.
The initial budget for 2011 is what I saw. In the preparation it was prepared for in 2010, at least as far as I could go back.
Yeah, it was before my time.
Okay.
And it had
okay.
been.
Yeah, because, yeah, me too.
Yeah, it was something the prior court administrator and judges had worked on to have implemented and hired. And then due to budget issues, they never went forward with it, and having lots of conversations with them and the continuing issues that we have in the courthouse, they decided this year that they would like to add this person to help with all of the IT and the AV over there. We currently have Kevin Love from the IT department over there quite frequently. it's almost every day for an hour, 2 hours, if not more, and that's not including all of the time that court admin staff have to devote to trying to figure out what the problem is.
Does Kevin satisfy those needs?
To the best of his ability, yes. I know that he's pulled too, and some of it's a funding issue and that type of thing, things that we need that aren't there, and we're trying to work with equipment that's probably 10 plus years old. And it's to take care of all of the court's IT business processes to make sure that the courts are able to function and have audio and have video at any time, as well as to work with the IT department to get a specialist.
How does that fall? I see a salary in here. How does that
the
match up with what we...
There was a very fingernail version of a job description that I think the previous administrative person had pulled together as part of that initial preparation. It is very fingernail, and at that time none of that had gone through for grading or evaluation, but based upon what I read that we have on file, the grade 22 that's on here is very, very high for those duties, because like for instance the individual that's servicing that right now is a grade 13, which is 34,000. I mean, a systems analyst, which is more complex, handling things in nature, is a 19. So in turn, that would, you know, first of all, is there enough 40 hours a week, every day of the week, to have a supportive position? And then I was wondering, do you have any hourly work time, like through the workflow system and such, to that we can look at how many hours are being dedicated to
as long as there's a ticket put in for
okay.
it. I know a lot of times that it's a phone call,
yeah.
and they're in the middle
okay.
of a court case or something, and in that respect there may not be a ticket open for it. We try to tell the guys, you know, if you get a call, go back and put in a ticket and have them close it, put in your resolution so I can look at that and see.
Yeah,
but I don't think it's going to be accurate. I mean, just because of the workload that they have, sometimes they just get in the weeds and it's hard to pull yourselves out of.
Yeah, we've been tracking as best we could the amount of time that Kevin has been working in the court the past several months, and it's anywhere from 20 hours to 60 plus hours that we have been tracking, because he does stuff for others too, and that's a month. So, and that's just doing like the emergency stuff, the things that have to be done right away. There's plenty of time, and it the judges also feel that this would help to address some things that they had previously spoken with you, Doug, and with you, Brian, about too.
Would this eliminate the need for IT to send Kevin or somebody else over there?
We would assume yes, unless they're maybe on vacation, and then maybe Kevin could.
But Brian, with that being, I'm going to call it decentralized, just for
mm-hmm.
just for this conversation. How would that work? You would still still work with your department.
So this is where centralized and decentralized get defined.
And this was a huge conversation last week in GMAS. So everybody knows it was huge. It would really come down to the roles defined for this position. What are they gonna do? You know, reading the description, and then based on those conversations that we had, I see a portion of the description leans on an individual to work will work to ensure separation of information owned by the judiciary and the rest of the county from the rest of the county departments. I mean, that's a whole different topic, and I think we've solidified that. But as far as the day-to-days, it's really more or less what I'm viewing with Kevin Love getting called.
a land technician type position, like what she's talking
yeah.
about. But with that, you know, once it, you don't want to take IT, which is wrapped around security in a very large way, and it's the big thing, and then give a staff from another department full administrative capabilities over all those computers, if that's going to be a role. I don't know what the roles are. I mean, I know audio video is a big one, and that I can certainly agree with you. But the other duties that are going to be assigned, I would be wary to stretch out security that far, to thin it out. I mean, it's difficult, because then at the end of the day, something happens and everybody points to IT. I'm not going to enlist for that responsibility. If security is charged to me, then I need to make sure that we encompass everybody. Because even though that whatever weakness may happen on their end, they may just go through court to get to something in finance. Mm-hmm. You know, it was just it was a portal. So we need to make sure that those duties are assigned clearly if this was to come to fruition. But I mean, I agree with Pat. I mean, a grade 22 for an IT business process coordinator based upon that description, I mean, I just think it's vague when knowing what Kevin does, being a land tech at 13.
I can guarantee it would be definitely more than just what Kevin does.
Well, and that's what I need to understand.
Because this person would represent the courts with the IT Governance Council, represent the courts, anything related to the judiciary and their IT and AD.
Right. Those are meetings, but I'm talking
right.
about their what is their responsibility, what's the role, what's their technical aptitude level got to be to answer to these current issues that are going to be applied. Now, as far as the conversations that we've had and the concerns of separating the data, you know, we still got a long way to go on that. I mean, that's a astronomical feat.
Right.
And it's going to break a lot of things if we ever chose to do it. You know, if that, and that being the case, one person would never be, if you were to take everything we do now and duplicate it just for judicial, it's not a one person job.
And I don't think that's what this is, but what I do hear y'all saying is that that if in fact this is a position that's budgeted, that if the roles will be defined, the skill set would be defined, experience, education, and then it would be graded appropriately based
Absolutely.
On what the needs are of the court.
Yeah,
current day.
Right.
Yeah, but a more robust job description, and
yes.
we need minimum
yes.
qualifications
okay.
clearly defined. But I would comfortably say though, it would still not rise to a grade 22. You probably, I mean, a systems analyst is a 19, it would probably be somewhere in between, because you're mixing land tech
mm-hmm.
responsibilities kind of with a system. So you're probably looking at really an estimated base, just roughly around 36.5,
okay.
not the 45.
And those numbers were just the ones that
I know,
happened.
That's
yeah.
way back when.
Right.
Yeah.
That's fine.
So.
Yeah.
Okay. I do agree with the need to have somebody that could be
salary lowered a little
right.
bit.
It's the beck and
yeah.
call
yes.
person, because when something happens in court,
yeah.
it's court, you know. So I agree with that, and that's what I've tried to make Kevin available as much as he can
yes.
be.
And it's been wonderful having that option. But.
Yeah.
What about, well, let me throw this out just as an idea. Your court schedule, when the judges are going to be there, and what if somebody was like a land tech was stationed out from IT in that general area to save that time frame and maybe service the stone building, the court? I don't know.
He already does.
Yeah.
He lives
does.
Over there then?
I mean,
so,
yeah, and he's right across the street, so typically, and Kevin will tell me, you know, they got
okay.
something going on, was told to stand by in case something happens. So he handles a lot of the at the desk tickets, remote tickets, things like that.
Because I just thought having it state, having it sounds from you like you need somebody right there to handle, so if somebody was stationed there, and you could still.
That's what we're looking for.
And another option would be, and obviously would include putting the position, but put the position in IT and let me just put him over there.
Yeah, that's why it was what I meant.
Make him the 100% available. You don't leave this building unless you're going to Burger King, you know, I mean.
I don't know if that would be acceptable to the judge.
Yeah, I don't know either. I just an option, just an option.
Yeah.
Do you have any vacancies now at that level?
I do. Not a land tech. No, not land tech.
No.
But I have one at a higher level.
End up being a?
I have one at an analyst.
Yeah, it's at a higher level, and I don't see this being that high.
Okay. All right.
Do you want to leave the dollar amount where it is for now, or?
Well, I think based on what I heard today, it's a bit high.
Yeah.
I think we could.
I think I'd be comfortable with the 36.5 that you said, the level 19 you said.
15.
That'll give us some leeway.
Yeah.
When you have to grade it out, give us some.
Yeah, that's where I see it.
You said that's a systems analyst?
No, that's a little bit below a systems analyst. It's at a, it's.
Which one?
A systems analyst is a 19, a land tech is a 13. This, if you melded the two, 15. You know, because I don't see it rising up to that on a day-to-day duties.
36.511, so.
Yeah.
Is that okay, fine? Change that, don't we?
I think that's okay.
Okay, all right.
36.
Plus benefits.
Yes, all of it, all of it.
About the operating expenses for that position at 14.3.
Some of that startup.
I can probably find it pretty easy, Don.
Probably have.
Office furniture. Telephone install, business cards, paper, office supplies, dues for the IT personal association, stationery, gas. I put gas in assuming that they would probably travel to off-site buildings if they needed help in juvenile or something like that as well. And that was only for a couple hundred. And then a BlackBerry.
Would this include magistrate coverage?
Let's just say that.
I think only if they really needed it, probably, yeah.
Okay, so mainly juvenile and superior and state.
Juvenile, superior, state, and magistrate too. I don't think they have too many needs there, but we would definitely be willing to let them do it.
That would assist you as well, Brian, if in fact this position assisted with those other courts. For those types of issues.
Well, you know, again, you're talking about, we're weighing peas and carrots to some degree, because we're assuming that this person would have all the same administrative capabilities and security rights and such that an IT staff member has, depending on their role.
Yeah, the issue of centralized versus decentralized.
And then the only other two things for operating expenditures for that would be taking the managing technology course through the Institute for Court Management and the attending the court technology conference, which happens every 2 years.
Okay.
And you indicated you have a spot, room space for the position.
It's anticipated that with the additional judicial space we would have.
Okay, and with the new judge.
Or if staff is moved or.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
We need to go over the general calendar first, or we already did that with the new judge.
DUNSO, we'll handle those.
So I think we got all the new budget items then.
State court, probably one.
Oh, no. What did I do with that?
Sam, there's what will state court pay for in legal fees? If you paid something last year, now you've got something in the budget for next year, then it comes to an issue.
Right.
we budgeted because we're not sure if there's gonna be anything else going on with one or two cases.
Oh, there it is, I found it.
And it's, you know, it's so difficult because we can just ask a simple question and then we get a bill and there, we don't have any money in legal fees for any of them, so. So they asked to put that.
We're still doing pretty good with jumping them on postage this year. And then last year, you anticipating any different activity as far as the volume of mail is concerned or just maybe the 2,000 still?
It's just, we did that because it went over for 2010 and it was over in 2009 too, it was over $2,000. It just happened not to be that much for 2011. I know they've started doing dead docket calls where they have to mail up to everybody.
Anything else this year? The books and periodicals, you had some plans for that?
I'm not sure if they do or not. That usually comes through later in the year when they're looking at, you know, renewals and things like that.
State court gave you in the books and periodicals?
That's what's always been in the budget.
It's just always been budget there.
Periodicals. They didn't have any actuals in 2010, they didn't have any actuals in 2011, but they did have actuals in 2009. 2009, they had about $1,600.
Bills, there's no money really to take anything from. So, I mean, we tell that it's really gone down over the years.
But we could look a little bit at the revenues and the fines and see what fine takes.
Go up there. How's the fines looking this year, too, in state court?
Let's see.
They're not tracking that fast yet. You bumped up the whole 5,000. So you're stepping out there then.
Well, just because they go down and, you know, they're going in.
So you hate to bump it up too much.
I know.
That's interesting.
Longer term, you're seeing a trend down.
Yeah, because in 2009 it was 1.7 million. 2010 1.6 and then 2011 1.4. No, so I did 12 and bumped it up to
12 because, you know, I tracked what we had currently done. Well, I pulled out what had been in the budget, what we had shown, and so I did as close as possible as I wanted to, because I don't know how it's going to be. I should have asked it with the new judge ship. Do you anticipate any increase in revenue anywhere with the new judgeship? Because that would be something good if we could, you know, put it in the budget.
It's hard to tell because, like David said, it's the same number of cases, but they are moving more quickly through the system.
Right.
So it's really, really difficult to tell if that will show a change, if we get any fines.
Right, right.
Let's give that some thought, though, then. And if it's reasonable to expect with, you know, the amount of cost for adding to the judgeship, it's reasonable to expect
a small, I mean, even
with adding 50% more cost on this side, it would seem reasonable to expect to add something more on the revenue side.
Just if it were something conservative, even very conservative, right?
Cover a small portion of the cost.
Right, and the only one that may be affected would be that.
The fines, the Superior Court.
Superior Court fines.
And then it, you really don't like.
But let's get that some consideration. I wouldn't mind increasing that just based on the fact that here's the cost for the additional judge, for the additional cases prosecuted, and it would just seem to make sense to increase that 50%, just like everything else.
Because that's in,
not 50%. I mean, it's like getting blood from a turnip. You're talking about sending people off to prison and trying to get money from them.
Right.
So it definitely is not going to be 50%.
It's in 1205.
But we booked 284 last year. Unless you're saying these additional cases moving along won't necessarily be
generating
fines.
Yeah, it's the same number of cases. Same number of criminal cases. And the fines only come from criminal cases.
Okay.
I mean, it'd be different if we were getting more civil cases in or able to charge fines on civil cases, which we don't.
Okay.
All right. This is lastly to
1231?
Pre-trial. Okay. Well, gee. We cut the $8,300 down to $6,500 in operating expenses.
Yes.
Don't know where to go from there.
Yeah.
That's
it's great.
That's enough to hold each line there open.
Yeah, and it's actually great. He just took out the travel, that he's just going to send one person there.
Okay.
And then we already went over the extra person for.
Right. Yeah. And then that was the one that had a reclass. We talked about that a little bit too, didn't we, Don? It would be a reclass to a pretrial release officer senior. And then the one in the new budget item is a pretrial release officer. So that would be three.
Right.
And there's, take a look at those, and if you see anything that's any errors, just when you get back, let us know if you see anything we've missed or what have you.
I will. Mm-hmm. And I'll talk to the folks on the special revenue funds.
Yeah, do that. Make sure they're comfortable.
And that's just on the fund balance, and then showing the differences in the grants.
Yes.
Make sure they understand.
Right, exactly. Make sure they're theirs are fairly easy because it's not, their grants aren't like full-time person.
Right.
You know, they just have some part-time, so theirs are fairly easy. But anyways, have them take a look. Make sure they're comfortable with it.
Yeah.
All right. Just did 6 budgets.
Yes.
And 1 new judgeship.
An hour and a half.
That's not bad. That's not bad.
If you have any more questions, so
okay.
I'll let
you
know.
You too. We'll be working this week. We have meetings the rest of the week. We'll be working next week on changes, et cetera, et cetera. So before the submission to the board, which is June 12th.
Yeah.
Right.
Vacation.
I'm going on vacation.
What?
I know. We'll approve that, right?
Approve that. No, that would be me. All right. Our job is done here?
Yes, we are done. We are done.
This is smiling like a...
Do you want me to back?
Just,
individual. We are taking state and federal grants.
That's
mine. To the new grant fund.
I think
you sure you got all that?
Yeah.
All kinds of grants.
Well, here. Take that. Thank you.
All right.
You're very nice.
For accounting purposes, which makes it much easier to report, keep track of grant expenses. Right now, grants are sort of commingled in various departments. and for our grant recording and all of you applying.
Okay.
It just, it's something that a lot of governments are doing separately.
Right, it's just, right.
I mean, it has to be turnkey ready.
Better way to manage them, to account for them. And where there's a county match, for example, like the senior services and all the grants over there, and where in the general fund, there's some county dollars, something to cover that.
Yeah.
What we'll show is a transfer out to the grant fund for the county share, for the general fund, whatever department is all.
Exactly.
So it'll be, I think, a little easier to see the county dollars that are matching.
But I'm talking about that number.
I came in just in time, huh?
Yeah, how does that happen?
All right, okay, that's fine.
And then Tim, too.
Yes.
Does that help understand that new grant coming?
Oh, you are coming.
I'm going to come, I don't know.
Two matches, one.
Oh.
Revenue that is in here for special purposes.
All right, we'll see you then.
The government county are all set up with a special revenue fund.
Yeah, I'm familiar with it.
Look at other.
I'll be seeing tomorrow.
But I've got.
Go to society secretary.
Okay, okay.
We've got a budget in.
My book's on the round table, so whenever you want to put it in there, you can.
I'll get it to you tomorrow.
Okay.
The member last year gave me earlier than our first meeting.
Okay.
Such and such, maybe.
Boy, did we have it by then last year? Wow.
I just got an email from Sandy on that.
Well, we were doing last week, we changed a lot of numbers.
Yeah.
We were aware about that. They have been used, they said that they would like to restrict it.
But that's the meeting. We probably have preliminary numbers for.
That's pretty soon.
Yeah. You know, all the things that are moving around, changing, we kind of communicate to them what the changes are.
Excuse me.
All right. We're good?
Excuse me?
I'm sure.
Okay. Do you have any figures on what overall the new judgeship is going to? I have a lot of questions, more expect figures, but I don't think I'll need most of them, so.
Initially.
You guys should just print one of these giant books for me, too.
You, would you really want a giant book? I don't know, there'll be a test later.
Okay.
Based on everything that was submitted from all these different offices.
Okay.
Right, came up with a final dollar amount just over a million.
Okay.
$1,045,781. Now, the question mark is, if you already heard it, is this capital number of $230,000? Because, you know, that includes leasing new space, you know, paying to renovate to set up a courtroom.
So that depends on how fast the new court is.
Yeah, I'd say the biggest question mark would be around that $230,000. I mean, no, this judgeship's going to be next year, so we have to have a place to put them. How we do that, it's not been determined.
And we don't know how to do the new.
It'll be in the courthouse, it'll be additional space outside the courthouse.
Okay.
To put, in other words, to put another judge in the current courthouse, if that's what they decided, then what's going to come out?
Right.
So those are the kinds of things you're still working on.
Do you need this room for something else?
Okay, sorry, we'll get out.
Right, but you got the, that's the main number there, so that's based on all the submittals.
And the only question mark is,